I think what you're trying to ask is, why am I so insistent upon giving out to them that blackness, that black power, that black pushing them to identify with black culture? I think that's what you're asking. I have no choice over it. In the first place, to me, we are the most beautiful creatures in the whole world, black people. I mean, and I mean that in every sense, outside and inside. And to me, we have a culture that is surpassed by no other civilization. We don't know anything about it. So again, I think I've said this before in the same interview, I think, at some time before, my job is to somehow make them curious enough, persuade them by hook or crook to get more aware of themselves and where they came from and what they are into and what is already there, just to bring it out. This is what compels me to compel them. And I will do it by whatever means necessary. When I'm finished working, as tired as I am, and my work completely takes all my energy, unfortunately. But when there are kids who come backstage afterwards, who want to talk, or who are moved to the point, sometimes they're moved to tears, I want to know more about it, and they shake my hand, and they kiss me, and they want to talk about their problems. I find the time to do so as much as I can. I discourage breakfasts and speeches because I don't make speeches, but I will go out of my way, in spite of the fact that I'm too tired to do it, to talk to them at least for 5 minutes or so, to sock to them the same message that I just finished doing on stage, and perhaps to hear some of their grievances, or just to make them feel that they are not alone. Because when you have a few colored kids in a huge white college, any way you cut it, they are alienated and they feel it. So when I come, I feel a responsibility. They're so glad to see me because I represent something to them. And I can't give them enough, you know. They need me. They need me. And when I'm needed, I have to give. I curse myself afterwards for having no voice, usually, and being so exhausted that I can't do anything for myself. But when they need me for. And the most important thing is, they are our future. It's an investment as far as I am concerned. When I invest time in young people from colleges, I know that I'm going to get that bread back. You know, bread cast upon the water comes back. Because when I see them doing their thing one day and I'm too old to do anything but sit and look at them, I'm going to say, well, I was part of that. I never intend for my children to look at me and be ashamed and say, Mama, why didn't you do something? I will have done mine. And so every time I talk to them, it's an investment.